Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, you're going to learn how to perform dilations. Dilations are a way for us to make objects as big or as small as we need them. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to perform dilations with and without a coordinate plane. First, we'll explore dilations, including places we see dilations in real life and important vocabulary we need for this topic. Next, we'll complete two dilations without a coordinate plane. And finally, we'll complete two dilations with a coordinate plane. In this lesson, you're going to need your straight edge and compass. You'll also need a ruler, which I know, I told you that's kind of like cheating in geometry, but this lesson actually needs us to measure. So pause the video now and gather these supplies. Let's begin with some examples of dilations in real life. We can compare older phones to the newer models to see a dilation, since most new models are bigger than the originals, but still kind of the same shape. Another example that you may have in your own kitchen is measuring cups, or measuring spoons, like these. The bottom spoon is the biggest, and the other spoons all still have the same circular shape, but they're smaller. These are both examples of dilations because the shape is being resized. Another example of dilations in real life is toy cars. Let's look specifically at this van. It's been reduced in size to become this toy van. The scale factor is what we multiply the pre-image by to get the image. And if our scale factor is between 0 and 1, the image will be smaller. The scale factor here is close to 1/70th, or approximately 0.014. Basically, if the original height of the van is 70 inches, we can use this equation to help us solve for the height of the toy van. This equation tells us to multiply the pre-image, which is 70, times the scale factor, or SF, of 1/70th. That gives us the image, or the height of the toy car. So when substituting in our values for the pre-image and scale factor, we get 1 inch as the height of the toy car. For the record, I am not a toy car designer, so these measurements aren't perfect, but I do think my estimation of the scale factor is pretty good here. Here's an example of some beautiful nesting dolls. These dolls have an immense history in the Russian culture and symbolism that I encourage you to research further when you finish today's schoolwork. And they are a perfect example of dilations. Let's explore dilations more by creating a line connecting the tops of the dolls and another line joining their bases. Where these lines meet is called the center of dilation. So let's say that the smallest doll here is our pre-image. Then the rest of the dolls are in enlargement because they're bigger than the pre-image, and it'll take a scale factor greater than 1 to create them. Let's explore the enlargement from the smallest doll to the one right next to it. We'll call this second doll our image. We know that the scale factor has to be greater than 1 for this image to be larger than the pre-image. Let's just say that the distance from the center of dilation to the top of the pre-image is 3 units. And we're given the scale factor of 3/2, or 1.5. We can use our formula and substitute 3 as the pre-image and 3/2 as the scale factor. When we multiply those, we get 9/2, or 4.5. This tells us that 4.5 is the distance from the center of dilation to the top of the image. The same scale factor applies to the base of the doll. So let's look at the middle of the doll's bases. If this length to the middle of the base is 2.7 units, and we multiply that by 3/2, we get 4.05. Here's my work for this. I encourage you to pause the video and go through these steps rather than just typing it into a calculator. It's good practice to know how to calculate this by hand for standardized tests and college entrance exams, but it's not the focus of this lesson. Anyways, That gave us the distance from the center of dilation to the middle of the base of this image. We know from earlier in this course that geometry all started with points, lines, and planes, and the use of a plain old straight edge and compass. A compass is definitely not something that's easy to use when our scale factor is not a whole number, but luckily for us, one of our dolls uses a scale factor of 6. The scale factor using the smallest doll as the pre-image and the largest doll as the image is 6. And since 6 is a whole number, let's give this straight edge and compass method a try. At this point, we would have already used a straight edge to get these lines and our center of dilation where they meet. Then we take our compass and adjust it so that the tip is on the center of dilation and the pencil can create a small arc. The first arc is made above the pre-image since its scale factor is 1. We're gonna have to be super careful to keep our compass setting the same and use it to draw 5 more arcs to add to the one we already have, since our scale factor is 6. We'll have to draw our arcs along this line to find where the image goes. Count to make sure that you see the 6 arcs. Perfect. Our 6th arc lined up right on top of the largest nesting doll, which is the image. Also, take note that the center of dilation, the pre-image point, and the image point are always collinear. This is something good to watch out for to make sure your image is ending up in the right place. You won't be expected to use a straight edge and compass much in this lesson. It would get too complicated with fractions and decimals, but it's still good to explore it a little and remember where geometry began, you know, over 2,000 years ago. Now that we've finished going through the vocabulary we'll need in this lesson, take some time to finish the vocabulary page of your notes template by pausing the video here.
Hey, I hope you've been learning a lot so far in this lesson, but now it's time for you to try drawing some dilations yourself. The next page in your notes reads, performing dilations without a coordinate plane. Take a look at the directions and then the example that's been done for you. Then do the next 2 practice problems. To do these, you're gonna need a straight edge, a compass, and a ruler. It is officially your turn. Pause the video now and try these examples on your own. All right, my studious students, it's almost time for you to try doing some dilations on a coordinate grid, but first, let's take a look at this key so that you can check your work. Pause the video one more time.
Now we're moving on to use a coordinate plane to complete our dilations. You can set that straight edge, compass, and ruler aside. This problem says to dilate by a scale factor of 1.5 about the point 6, 4 and find the following information. This means that the point 6, 4 is the center of dilation. First, always draw the center of dilation along with the lines connecting the vertices to the center of dilation. It's also a good time to write the vertices of the pre-image here. Then, let's figure out how many units away point A is from the center of dilation. Try to count units and the direction you're going. How would you describe how to get to point A from the center of dilation? If you said left 6 units and down 1 unit, that's exactly right. To show you my work and thought process, I'm going to write that here using L for left and D for down as a shortcut. Now we can apply the scale factor by multiplying by 1.5. 6 times 1.5 is 9, so we can write L9, or left 9. 1 times 1.5 is still 1.5, so we can write down 1.5. We have just figured out where to move to place A prime. We have to start back at the center of dilation and move left 9 units and down 1.5 units. I want you to have some think time here. So you try to find B prime and C prime on your own. Also, give yourself some time to go back in the video to rewatch anything if it'll help you in any way. Pause now so you can go do these things. Let's see if you were able to get the correct coordinates for B prime and C prime. To get from the center of dilation to point B, we have to move left 2 units and down 2 units. We can multiply each of those by the scale factor of 1.5, and we get left 3 and down 3. Starting back at the center of dilation, we move left 3 units and down 3 units to sketch in B prime. Now we can move on to point C. We notice that there isn't a horizontal movement from the center of dilation to point C. That actually makes finding C prime much easier than the others. Point C is 5 units down from the center of dilation. Multiplying this by 1.5 gives us down 7.5 units. Moving down from the center of dilation 7.5 units allows us to place C prime at the point 6, negative 3.5. Then we can sketch in the entire image and answer the final 2 parts of the question. All points on the pre-image move somewhere new to become the image, so there are no invariant points. Also, the transformation is not an isometry because it does not maintain its original size. Our final example says to dilate about the origin, which is 0, 0. It may seem strange that the center of dilation is where point C is on our object. It actually makes this problem easier than the last. So use your instincts. Even if something seems strange, it's likely you're doing it correctly. So complete this entire problem by yourself. Pause the video now. So we don't need to draw the center of dilation, because we already have point C drawn there. We'll just dilate about point C, and drawing the lines connecting to the center of dilation to any other vertices means tracing over the sides of the triangle. We can write the vertices of the pre-image and then move on to find A prime. Point A is 4 units right and 4 units down from the center of dilation, so we can make note of that using R for right and D for down. Now we can apply the scale factor by multiplying by 1/4, or 0.25. This gives us right 1 unit and down 1 unit. Starting back at the center of dilation, we move right 1 and down 1 and place A prime. Now that we've gotten through part of the problem, go ahead and make sure you're confident in your work for B prime and C prime before we check those answers. Let's see if your coordinates for B prime are correct. To get from the center of dilation to B, we move right 6 units and up 4 units. We can multiply each of those by the scale factor of 1/4, and we get right 1.5 units and up 1 unit. Starting back at the center of dilation, we move by these new distances and sketch in B prime. Now we can move on to point C. We notice that there isn't a horizontal movement or a vertical movement from the center of dilation to point C, since point C is on the center of dilation. Multiplying no movement by a scale factor is still no movement. This means that C prime is in the same place that C was. Then we can sketch in the entire image and answer the final 2 parts of this question. All points on the pre-image move somewhere new to become the image, except for point C, since point C was on the center of dilation. Also, the transformation is not an isometry because although it maintains its original shape, it does not maintain its original size. Now you can perform dilations with and without a coordinate plane. Remember that reductions make the image smaller than the pre-image, and enlargements make the image bigger than the pre-image. See you next time. Hey, hey.